So we turn our attentions to what's about to come. John Virgo leading 7-2 against Gary Wilkinson, but the match we're going to follow live just after 3 o'clock is Stephen Hendry against Alain Robidoux. Now, this man, John Spencer and Jack Carnham, are commentating.
Almost a similar type shot to the previous one he played. And again, another mistake. And how often do you see two consecutive foul shots in the opening shots of the frame?
Yes, and rather fortunately for Stephen there, it looks as though the black has gone in a safe position and the pink tied up, so Alain have to try and get down for the blue off this. Both players showing a little pressure here. And this is the type of shot we used to see in Stephen knock in, stunning round the back of the pack, back towards the bulk end of the table.
Well, Stephen must be wondering which game he's playing. He'll get it all out of his system soon enough. That's a good shot. Just played that aside to pop the ball. That was much more tricky than it looked.
Thirteen, Stephen Hendry.
Well, 13 points, some say unlucky 13, but I think Stephen will be pleased to have knocked three or four balls in to ease the tension a little.
And that's not the best shot in the world from Alain. Meant to rest in the pack of reds, but giving Stephen chance of this red into the corner.
One.
looking at a plant there, but of course left the white at such a position that he will be going to the balk end of the table should he miss it. And this certainly the best chance so far of the frame.
Well, that was most unlike Stephen. And this is the sort of opportunity Alain wants to get a nice easy start. Well, that's come out rather nicely. Gives him a nice natural angle here to
We're
a little steep on the black, but let's see how he handles that.
May just have overrun a fraction there. has to play this rather slow with a lot of bottom to get into those reds. And looking at Alain's face, nothing will go.
Safe without leaving anything.
Alain Robidoux.
Not the best of safety shots.
Sixteen, Stephen Hendry.
No, he's short. My word, he'll be disappointed with that.
Yes, still has the red into the centre. Would have liked to have been straighter on this.
Nine.
Alain just checking the board there, which tells him he wants the black followed by the yellow and green to make this frame safe. Stephen has to hit this, otherwise he will require snookers.
Alain having a look at this, and he might well try this. That really was a brave shot.
And now the vital shot of the first frame.
The first frame goes to Stephen Hendry, and what a frame. Seesaw, backwards and forwards. There were times, John, when first I thought Stephen was going to take it, and Robidoux had his chance, and it was backwards and forwards. I think it was governed by nerves generally, but what a splendid opener.
Yes, I think we're in for a very interesting match here, Jack. But I think the turning point of the whole thing was that brown that Stephen played into the yellow pocket at that pace when he'd been out of touch. Took a lot of courage and a tremendous clearance under pressure. And I feel Alain must be feeling a little sick now, especially after the green he missed to clinch the frame.
Yes, I'd agree with that, John.
Second frame, Stephen Hendry to break.
And that could be a bad time for Alain to let Stephen in straight away. Confidence must be a lot higher now after just winning that first frame.
Seven. 14, 19. Thirty-five.
Rather unfortunate double kiss there, would have been safe otherwise.
Five.
that's the first really aggressive stroke we've seen, and it's paid dividends.
Yes, and I think it just goes to show, Jack, what the confidence the first frame has given him. Having said that, he's left it rather short on the blue here.
Well, he was inch perfect there.
Yes, and already at the point where just requires one more red. Just a 69. Nice little touch of side there, just holding him beautifully for the yellow. Well, the frame goes to Stephen and gives him a two-frame lead. And the pink there, of course, was unimportant, but that frame was three visits for Stephen, including the break. And I think we began to see
the real Stephen there. And unfortunately for Robidoux, who in my opinion is he looks like a future world champion to me, but my word, he had something to compete with there, John. That was good stuff.
Yes, he let Stephen in, of course, very early on there. And the way Stephen played there, I'm afraid Alain's going to have a job to put the blocks on him, because when Stephen gets in this mood, if he gets the chances, he takes them. Looked a completely different player than he had done in the first frame. However, let's see what Alain can do with this frame.
Seven. Fourteen.
So a good start then for Stephen Hendry. We're just nipping away for the news now, back with that match afterwards. And that's the end.
Welcome back to this year's Embassy World Championship. Good afternoon from me. I'll be with you now right the way through till 5:30. And then, of course, we've got our night program when we bring you all the top action and the stories of day 5 here at the Crucible. This is what's been happening so far today. Tony Knowles has got through. He's beaten Tony Chappell. Tony Chappell didn't play at all well today, and Knowles is through, and he'll next play Terry Griffiths. Tony Mio has started out against Wayne Jones. As you see, that completes the night. The score at the moment, 5 to Wayne Jones, 3 to Tony Mio. They were pulled off one frame because they hadn't completed a lot of sessions, so a lot of work for them to do tonight. John Virgo is resuming today against Gary Wilkinson. Virgo played very well yesterday to have that lead of 7-2, playing to a finish today. Stephen Hendry is the big match here this afternoon. He's playing Alain Robidoux. You were watching it earlier. Hendry taking the first two frames, and there's something to look forward to. Jimmy White comes into the competition tonight to play Danny Fowler. But we'll go right now to Stephen Hendry and Alain Robidoux. Robidoux is the French-Canadian, a very good one. He was the linchpin of Canada's win, really, in the World Cup. This is his debut here at the Crucible. As you saw, he's lost the first two frames. Stephen Hendry at the table now. He's yet to score, and Robidoux has 14 points. So Hendry to play. Your commentators, Jack Carnham and John Spencer.
Stephen
Hendry,
4,
Alain Robidoux.
So, Alain in hand, but unfortunately, nothing really to go at.
Foul 4, Alain Robidoux.
So although that's a mistake from Stephen, no colours available for Alain.
Five. 5, Alain Robidoux.
And that was quite an unbelievable miss there from Stephen.
And suddenly Alain is really back into the game. He's full of concentration now. Still the red over the left centre pocket. Just looking at the board, 53 points in front. So red.
39.
Needs at least one more red after this green to put the frame safe. Great attempt Alain's made there, but rather unlucky. The vital red. And of course he's so well aware of the power of Stephen that dread a mistake now. Points on the table.
Bye. Five, Alain Robidoux.
A bit unlucky there. He nine times out of ten with a double kiss like that, the red would drop.
One, Alain Robidoux. And the French.
So Stephen concedes and Alain Robidoux pulls one back. 2-1-2, Stephen Hendry.
Epic moment then for the French Canadian, the first frame he's ever won in the Crucible Theatre in the World Championship, the debut maker. Rapidly rising star, he's got some form, he was in the semi-final of the Rothmans in 88, he's been in a semi-final, a quarter-final of two ranking tournaments this season. Played well, of course, in that World Team Cup. Here he is then, in the chair, watching Hendry breaking off frame four.
Six. Seven.
15. Twenty-six. Thirty-four. Thirty-five.
And made sure he had the angle there to go into the pack of reds.
Happened to Alain there? A rush of blood. It could have been a lot worse, in fact.
Well, it doesn't appear actually, Jack, that he's done any damage whatsoever. All the reds blocking one another into this right-hand corner pocket. May have a go at the red into the yellow pocket.
Eight.
9.
Well, that's a surprising miss by Stephen. Didn't appear to be any problems there, but Alain certainly got a chance here.
Yes, and even if he'd have potted that, Jackie, he was way out of position on the black.
Nine.
And that was very unlucky there for Alain. Kiss on either of those two reds. Now, a bit of trouble. Can pot this into left-hand corner pocket, of course, but would be going into the pink. Well, whatever he played there, it was a dreadful kick he got on the brown there. Stephen just asking for the white to be cleaned.
Seven. Eight. 13.
And this is one of the key shots. Doesn't look that to have the angle to get behind the red, so having to run through around the angles. And I'll be delighted with that shot.
21.
Well, this is the big one. Colours virtually on this spot, apart from brown. So if it gets on the yellow, and he has, so he's now in familiar ground.
28.
Well, he's overdone that a little, that's a pity. Just 13 points behind, 22 remaining. That's a pity. That didn't need all the pace, but he lost his way a little there.
Yes, may have been a little fortunate to going off into the centre pocket there. Stephen would have had a much easier blue had it at the angle of the pocket. So 14 in front, just the blue required.
That's an excellent pressure shot by Stephen there. So the pink goes in, and at the interval, Stephen Hendry leads by 3 frames to 1.
Good start by Hendry against an opponent that a lot of people thought would give the young Scotsman a lot of trouble, making sure it's a first round match, but there's a long way to go yet. As Jack said, they're on the interval at the moment. We will be back with that match in this programme. We're on until 5:30, but let's have a check on the state of the championship here. And as you can see, Tony Knowles a winner today. And the other match going on this afternoon is the resumption of the one between John Virgo and Gary Wilkinson, where Virgo, the number 13 seed, had that 7-2 lead from yesterday. As I promised you, we're going back to the other match you were watching, the big match of the afternoon. And here, just about 5:20 in the Crucible Theatre, the players just coming out. Robidoux and Hendry. Hendry 3 frames, Robidoux 1, and Robidoux had a chance actually to make it level, but made a bad mistake in 4th frame. So here he goes now then, live in the Crucible this afternoon, Robidoux 1-3 down.
13.
And Alain breaks off, and a little short of the bottom cushion, which is important in this sort of match.
Thank you.
6.
Well, Alain must try and take advantage of the 5 open reds here.
Alain Robidoux.
And that's a terrible mistake there by Alain. Looked to just come up a bit off the shot. May have gone too hard for the red over the corner, but always have the reserve one over the left-hand centre.
Stephen, an excellent opportunity then of crashing the pack with that red there.
25.
Yes, and he's opened quite a few more reds up there, Jack. So an excellent chance here for Stephen to get a sizable break together.
46. Stephen Hendry.
trifle unlucky there. He might have been better had he have continued down and taken a smaller colour, but he's got to work with a cue ball here. And, well, he's had perhaps a little bit of good luck there.
Six.
Yes, he's left himself a little bit straight here. Might just as well to get his composure and take his time.
15.
Just over hit it a little. With an excellent chance if he can pot this of going into the three reds. Paid the penalty there for just overrunning. So 25 points the difference.
Fourteen. Fifteen. Twenty. Twenty-two. 22, Stephen Hendry. And the frame.
And Alain Robidoux concedes the frame, and it's 4-1 to Stephen Hendry. And again there, John, a very polished performance. What can one say about Stephen Hendry? He really is playing so well. But on the other hand, Alain, he's had the winning of two of the frames that he's lost. So I get the feeling maybe that it's the excitable character in him that perhaps is robbing him of the vital pot.
Yes, I was just going to say the same thing, Jackie. He missed a simple green to win one of the early frames that Stephen went on to win. He missed the blue in the frame before the interval, and the black off the spot just then, although that black wasn't too easy, but certainly could have won a couple of the frames he's lost.
So Stephen continues.
Thank you.
Alain Robidoux.
And again, I'm afraid he certainly can't afford to keep missing chances like that. He wants to get back into this match. Yes, Alain seems to be rushing one or two shots. Not the best of positions, but can knock this blue in.
He certainly opened the reds, but black being straight gives him a better opportunity off a long pink here. And one senses the fact that Stephen is beginning to buzz.
Seven. Hendry. One.
6. Fourteen, Alain Robidoux.
And again, we see Alain build up a nice lead, but then let Stephen in and may have thrown the whole lot away.
One.
Although that's not the best shot in the world from Stephen.
Well, just a little more thought now. He's got to be thinking about reds. Well, it appears that he could hold the cue ball for the right-hand red. Yes, that's quite straightforward.
19.
Into the lead.
37.
Got to give this one a bit of a punch.
He's certainly making Alain pay very dearly for all of his mistakes. But this one he's left here isn't too easy. And 25 points in front, just needs the red and colour. So a chance now for Alain to pinch a frame. All the colours on the spot.
Well, that's something I haven't seen before, and Stephen was very annoyed there and said a few naughty words to himself there.
One.
He's been in this position before. Can he go on and clinch the frame from it?
Eight.
Yes, on the very vital shot here, he's just gone a fraction too far. He's got to use the rest. Using quite a long extension here with his bat. Now he can play this without the rest. No, he's going to use it. He very often plays without the rest because with a much longer reach.
And again, not the desired position on the blue. Should have been looking into the blue into one of the centre pockets there. So more pressure.
Oh, well done. Well done. Black ball game, and this is very important for Alain. Oh, tremendous relief there for Alain Robidoux. He pulls one back, 4-2 to Stephen Hendry.
Yes, he will be relieved at that. We're watching this match live here in the Crucible this afternoon, just while they're waiting for the next frame, which we're going to see as much as we can. Let me tell the Gary Wilkinson fans, their man's doing well. He's pulling back. He's won three in a row this afternoon from being 7-2 down, so there's now just two in it between him and John Virgo at 7-5. If you've just come in, the other news this morning that Tony Knowles has got through there, that top match on our list, 10-4 against Tony Chappell, the Welshman not playing at all well today. Knowles will now play Terry Griffiths. Tony Meehl is two frames adrift against Wayne Jones. They only managed to get eight frames through in their session. That match, if you look down the bottom, is played to a finish tonight. And that's in the same part as the Stephen Hendry Alain Robidoux match, which you've just seen has gone to 4-2. And the big news, Jimmy White comes into the Crucible tonight to play his first round match against Danny Fowler. So there's the up-to-date situation as it's happening here this afternoon on day five. And what's happening in the Crucible at the moment on day five is Stephen Hendry and Alain Robidoux resuming Robidoux having won that frame very well, 4-2, he's the breakup.
Again, Alain's rather short there, and Stephen very often knocks these in.
Six, Stephen Hendry.
Well, that was rather a sweet one. I wonder if that could be a turning of the tide.
Five. Alain Robidoux.
Well, one could sense that Alain, he was reluctant to go to the cushion and come back for the black. That's a pity. Had a fine chance there.
Six. 14.
Well, that's a pity. Alain's got two square on that. He's playing for the two reds just above the black. And, well, if he's wise, I think he'll settle for a good safety here. So, 32 points ahead.
Yes, Jack, and that was one of the shots I was surprised Stephen didn't play the previous shot when he had to go at the red into the green pocket. Take one or two risky shots on Stephen. Didn't play the kiss on the green there, but still got a red into this left-hand corner pocket.
One. Seven.
These are torturous moments for Alain. He 50. Takes a lead in every frame, it appears, 30, 35 points, and then makes a mistake and has to suffer watching Stephen wipe it all away.
Six, Stephen Hendry.
Stephen having a good look there. I think the red goes fairly comfortably in the centre as long as he's not too far from it. Well, it's just as well that he didn't get the green, I think. there's no doubt he had that in mind. If the strength of the shot is anything to go by, he played both aspects, safety and the double. Let's give him the benefit of the doubt. So Alain now 3 points behind and every chance here. So just keep his cool and hold himself together.
Pity that was for Alain Robidoux as we're coming up to the end of this program, having a great fight back, and he did well to get to 2-4 at 49-43, and he really needed that ball, didn't he? Anyway, there's a long, long way to go in that one, and it's going to be a great match. We have got a program tonight, and Hendry might well wrap this up now, I think. The news on the Virgil-Wilkinson match. Wilkinson's done well. He's just a frame adrift at 7-6. That's it till 11:20. Stand by for Jimmy White. The semi-finalist has got through to the second round here. He's beaten Tony Chapel of Wales 10-4, and Tony Knowles will play Terry Griffiths in the next round. And also John Virgo had a very good overnight lead at a very bad opening session here this afternoon. Gary Wilkinson came back at him to take 4 in a row, but Virgo is through by the score of 10-6. Let's see all that fits into the top half of the draw. And it's the half where Steve Davis, defending champion, will play Steve James, the man who knocked out Alex Higgins. Willie Thorne will play Neil Folds, who knocked out the 85 champion Dennis Taylor. Terry Griffiths, as I've said, will play Tony Knowles, and John Virgo waits to see whether he plays Jimmy White or Danny Fowler, as I say, one of our big feature matches here in this programme. Cast your eyes into the second half of the draw. Look first at the bottom, where you can see the pairings. John Parrott will play Dean Reynolds. Doug Mountjoy will play Cliff Thorburn. Mike Hallett, who really had a struggle to beat Steve Newbury, will play Darren Morgan, a young Welshman who knocked out the 86 champion Joe Johnson. And two matches to be finished. Tony Meo and Wayne Jones will finish tonight in this program. And we also have Stephen Hendry and Alain Robidoux. Hendry and Robidoux started out today. Hendry took the first 2 frames. Robidoux came back. And to be honest, Robidoux lost a couple of frames he should have won. And in our last program, we had Hendry ahead by the 1 frame, 4-3. Robidoux is the French-Canadian. He was the big star of the Canadian team in the World Team Championships. He's making his debut here in the Crucible. 4-3 then to Hendry. Let's join the next frame. No points are scored yet. And Robidoux, like so many Canadians, likes the plant shot. There's a chance on there. Jack Carnham and John Spencer will commentate.
That's one out of the book. What a cracker.
Yes, Jack, I suppose you could call that a plant double.
Well, Stephen must consider himself a little fortunate then. Sheer pace kept that out the pocket. In fact, it went in the pocket, but bounced and hit the back of the leathers. And now has the perfect angle of wishing to go into the reds. I'm sure they'll split this time. Got into the white that time. This isn't too easy. Awkward bridging.
Nine.
But certainly a good chance of putting a few points together now.
What do you think? 27.
I think Stephen's heart was in his mouth there. No, it won't be. 61 points in front, 59 on the table.
Seventy-four. 94.
Well, that wasn't necessary, but not important. So, a very, very nice break indeed from Stephen Hendry. Gives him a cushion of one frame now to lead by 5 frames to 3.
Nearest we've come to a century so far today. Fellow Canadian Cliff Thorburn watching Robidoux here on a television monitor. So I'm not too surprised at that. Robidoux is a terrible starter. I'm happy with the score so far. Into the next frame, it's in progress. There's the score. The next player you'll see will be Hendry.
Thank you. 15. Twenty-eight. Twenty-nine. Thirty-four. Thirty-four, Stephen Hendry.
So 24 ahead, and a fighting chance here for Alain.
One.
Well, there's certainly nothing easy about the two reds. Well, that was a brilliant one, and what is more, he's given himself a chance to attack the red on the side cushion. Now looking for the kiss, but never mind, he's just 10 behind, so he's well in the match.
Thank you.
Stephen's gone too far. Now, I don't think Alain can pop the red. He may be able to, but it looks tight. Well, it looks as though he can. Yes. Certainly looking for a yellow there that without having to disturb the brown, but that he can't avoid now, which complicates things a little. Extension that is, no rest here. Great stuff.
Two, Stephen Hendry.
Worthy of applause, tremendous shot.
Thank you.
Stephen fell into the trap there.
Well, four.
Played that too hard. And he's maybe a little fortunate that he's gone in the pocket. So there's just 5 points the difference. One good pot. And a scoreline that would be very pleasing to Alain. So he just needs the pink. Yes. And my word, Alain Robidoux will be delighted. So he takes the frame to trail by the odd one of 9-5-4.
Good day for Robidoux and a good match there in prospect. They in fact finish tomorrow night. They play to finish tomorrow night. You can see it in Sports Night, in fact. And the winner will play the winner of the match between Tony Meo and Wayne Jones. And there's the score after their first session. Meo two frames down to the Welshman at 3-5. They play to a finish here tonight, and we will see it in this program. And after that, stand by for Jimmy White, who enters the tournament here this evening. And we'll have a lot of coverage of that because we're on here tonight until about 1:30. You'll see a lot of Jimmy White. I can promise you some entertainment. I also did tell you about an important meeting going on here in Sheffield tomorrow of the WPBSA, the governing body of the game. They've got an extraordinary general meeting. And there is a proposal to increase the number of professional players. There are about 120 odd at the moment. Proposal to increase it to about 207. The proposal is to invite 34 amateur players in as full professionals, to reinstate a number, about 31 in all, of non-tournament professionals, that are professional players not playing in tournaments at the moment, and to give full snooker status to 13 billiards-only professionals. There's a couple of other ideas about levies on prize money and more foreign players. Now, there's a little bit of controversy about this because the members are being asked to vote on this as one proposal. They can't vote on one part and reject the other. It's a total proposal they've got to vote on. And then if that does go through, and there's some doubt about that, the board say that gives them a mandate to do something else. They can invite the women's world champion, Alison Fisher, in as a full professional. The players do not get a vote on this at all. If they vote for the other proposal, then the board say they invite Alison Fisher in as a full professional. Now, the problem there is there are a number of other players who have finished above Alison Fisher in the rankings, and they won't get in. So they're buzzing a bit at the moment, and many amateurs are up in arms about it. The other problem is the voting procedure of the WPUSA. There are voting members. They vote first, and then if they put it through, the whole members of the WPUSA vote. And only snooker could actually have the House of Commons and the House of Lords in reverse order. But many players, as I say, are not too happy about this. We'll see what happens tomorrow. But Tony Knowles was a man who won his match here today, and he made his views quite clear about it all.
Voting against opening the game up for the wrong reasons. Eventually, there will be too many tournaments for top-class pros, and the pros will have to go overseas and play tournaments and play around the world. So then your next lot of professionals will be playing in tournaments over here, just the same as golf did. I mean, Davies can't keep playing in every tournament, and the rest of the players. There'll be tournaments selected tournaments for them to play in. And that's the way it's got to go.
Well, that's Tony Knowles' view, and just to sum it up, they feel, in fact, that it is a vote for Alison Fisher coming into the association or not, something they've not been allowed to vote on. The meeting is tomorrow at 12 o'clock, and we'll give you news of that, how it happens. But it is an important meeting, but it's caused a lot of hassle in snooker. Anyway, let's see if we can get some, not hassle, but entertainment going now with the match, I promise you, between Danny Feller and Jimmy White.
6. Seven. 13.
And that time, not what Alain intended, was playing to miss the pack of reds.
Certainly spread very nicely. And Alain, he's riding high at the moment. And the very few players can do that.
36.
Wrong side of the blue, but enough angle to go in and out of bulk, and with the green being off at its spot, of course, a clear path. Thirty-seven.
That's a brilliant shot by Alain. He's really spread the reds beautifully and nicely on the pink. And Alain's highest break of the match so far. And coming just at the right time.
Yes, and certainly looking solid this evening. And from nothing here, he's built a frame winning opportunity. Now 58 points in front. Rather annoyed himself there, just not gone far enough, but just requires the pink and one more red to leave Stephen needing snookers. So 66 points ahead with 59 remaining. So Stephen now requiring snookers.
66. Stephen Hendry didn't get the snookers he required.
Alain is certainly queuing very well indeed. It's quite a powerful stun shot he played there, and he was very accurate.
17.
34.
And Elaine's certainly making Stephen pay for every mistake.
His head suddenly drooped a little. Let's hope he's not losing heart.
31.
Well, Elaine doesn't look too happy with that shot, but there are two red at the back of the pack will go, in this left-hand corner. Not quite on the red he played for. Could take the one into the centre.
5. Has he run out of reds?
52.
That's a good shot.
Alain Robidoux.
Well played. And it's in Alain's favour that he's actually snookered him on that red over the middle pocket.
Well, Steve was actually playing a plant into this right-hand corner pocket there, but was so far away, he's given Alain another excellent chance here. Already 58 points in front.
Thank you.
the size of colours unimportant. Now it's a question of just disposing of a couple of reds to reduce Stephen's scoring power, and that's it.
So just one more red required to put this frame safe.
14.
Stephen concedes, and at the interval, Stephen Hendry trails by one frame, 7-6.
Neck and neck. Remember, first player to 10 frames takes the match. Well, Hendry came back in the next frame to square things once again, 7-7. On to frame 15. We join it with Hendry at the table. He's 14-0 down.
Stephen Hendry.
Been fouled there, and I don't think he knows why. And just look at the position he's left, Stephen.
What?
Stephen's certainly back in his old rhythm now.
Thirty-six. Thirty-seven.
7.
This could certainly prove crucial to Alain. Second frame in a row, 51. This, but he's virtually been kept away from the table.
Yes, John, plus the fact that if in his mind that he's not aware of what happened, that is very unsettling indeed, which is most unfortunate at this crucial time.
58.
And he will not get up, I fear. And indicates so. And the frame score goes 8-7 in favour of Stephen Hendry.
So Stephen Hendry, two frames short of first round victory, and Alain Robidoux certainly a little unsettled by that push shot decision against him. So frame 16, Robidoux is at the table, and we get to see the first points.
Much doubt there, he was looking for the black, and he played it so well that he killed the cue ball, didn't get any run at all, just wanted a couple of inches run forward. So the pink is available, but not easy for reds.
Well, a tremendous pot there by Stephen. Finished on the black, but I'm quite certain he was trying to go round the angles and down for the blue there. Potting this red will certainly be disturbing some more reds. Probably try and power it through for the black.
17. Thirty-two. 33. Forty-four. 52. 53. 58. 59. 67.
So he's got just enough points left. 75. Things coming good for Stephen just at the right time.
80. 81.
Yes, suddenly he's nearly potting the red there before the referee had spotted the blue.
88. 88.
Well, groans of disappointment from the audience, but nevertheless, a lovely break.
Stephen Hendry finding his form, and he went on to wrap up the match with victory in the next frame to move on to the second round. Bit of sympathy for Robidoux, who never got back into his stride after being penalised for that push shot in frame 15, referee John Street calling the decision against him. This was Robidoux's reaction at the press conference afterwards.
I would like to see a replay, you know, really, because... I'm not sure at all, you know. When he called four, it was a push shot, but I mean, like, I didn't feel I pushed the ball there. He thought probably I play a follow through, but I didn't play a follow through. I just played a stunt shot to get an angle on the ping, so I did exactly what I wanted to do, you know what I mean? I'm just, I was surprised he called a foul there because I didn't think I made one there, so. I mean, like, you see, he's the referee. I mean, like, if he thought I made one, I made one, you know, so what can I say?
Look pretty tough. Two second round matches underway today, 25 frame matches. Here's how they stand. Steve Davis leading Steve James by 5-3. And John Parrott and Dean Reynolds all square at 4 frames apiece. Well, tomorrow's first visit to the